All right, here we are, PCA Sim Racing Series 8, Race 1, Watkins Glen with the classic boot configuration. Fun track, fun group. We'll see how we do. Managed to qualify P20.
That's the end of the session, 20th place.
With a 145.174, which is actually a little slow. I did a 144.7 earlier, but wouldn't have made a whole lot of difference. So we're going to grid. This will be a standing start, and we'll see how we do.
All right, can we get everybody on the grid, please? Everybody on the grid, just remember to don't let the car roll until you're ready to take off. Good luck.
Find the go bowling signs along the main street to be a tad unsettling at the standing start.
P20. The track temp is 69. The air temp is 66 Fahrenheit. Okay, Chip, get ready. Green, let's go, let's go.
Almost followed him right off track.
Hold the brakes.
So up six positions in one lap, that isn't horrible, I guess. Damn it. Fuck me. Just got loose.
Pretty thin, Andrew.
1X. Fuck. Better than Hitman, but shit.
Okay, Chip. There's a car exiting the pits. Heads up. Make him do all the work. Focus on your exits. P12. Let him get away.
Nice clean pass there, Jack.
P13. 7-0,
Penny.
Okay, Chip. Don't let this guy distract you.
I'm gonna find another solution for that fucking turn.
Hey, Jay, don't worry about me. Just, let's not lose touch with the front leaders here.
Okay, Chip. Pit window open.
Appreciate it, Jake.
Thanks, Jake.
The track, force him to find the gap.
Nice move, Georgie.
Thank you, Mike. Thanks, pal.
P14.
Gary, you're making progress, so I'm going to stay back behind.
If I'm holding you up, let me know.
Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm a lap down.
Thanks, man.
Come on, Chip. Keep pushing. We might get him back. Box in 940 feet. Feet. 100 feet.
You don't have to do that, Andrew. Expand, you'd have to do that.
Pit exit's clear.
Hey, you're welcome, Michael.
Davis is closing in. The gap is now 3.9.
Nice move, Ben. Now get us around Volker.
Thanks, David.
Sector 1 is 0.6 off the pace.
I'm going to lift, Sean. Thanks, Jack.
Back there, Tim. I don't know if he caught that, Ken, but I'm just going to hang back.
Third place. Your last lap time was a 146.09. The gap to Davis behind is now 4.3 seconds.
Appreciate it, Donald.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. 20 minutes remaining. You've got 20 minutes left. All right, Chip. Halfway home. Fuel's good. Second place, fastest lap.
Yes, sir.
Apex is lava. I do not drive like driving this car as much as I like the 99. I'm sorry, baby. I didn't mean to insult you.
The car ahead's pitting now.
Didn't mean to insult you. It's okay. You can be just as temperamental as the 991. Thank you for proving that. Holy crap.
P21.
Nice move, Patrick.
Shit sticks. No, as I was about to say, I prefer the 991 over the 992. I just didn't.
I'm going to pit then.
It's not as numb. This car is so numb.
All right then.
Okay, Chip. Ignore that fucker in the mirror. Stick to your line. Nail those exits.
Chip, such language.
Thank you.
It's nice and trade on let us draft. interesting.
B14. Just keep it smooth, no mistakes.
Car 43 should be there. It's unfortunate. Come in this time by, take a look. Car 43, you should be good to go.
Thank you.
Thanks, David.
Yeah, no problem. You don't have to give it back, though.
Okay, Chip. Hold your nerve. Just keep it smooth. No mistakes.
But Bruce, go man, go.
Okay, third time's a charm, Nick. Let's see if you can get it done, brother. I am not home. There you go. Thank you. Nah. Shit.
Thank you, Ed.
Damn it all.
P17.
Damn it, damn it, damn it. Come on, baby.
Sector 3 is 0.6 off the pace.
Maybe you take the inside at the end of the strip.
That's 5 minutes to go. 5 minutes. All right, Chip. Don't think about the lap times. Just hit each and every apex.
I got squirrels for tires right now.
Well done, Ben. Thanks, Volker. I had a good view of that. Nicely done.
gap ahead is now 1.2. Sector 1 is 0.41 off the pace. That's 2 minutes left. 2 minutes. B16. Nice one, Chip. Good pass. Nice front.
Hunting we will go, a hunting we will go. Hi ho, the Dario, a hunting we will go. Oh, come on over here, doesn't help you.
How you doing, George?
I don't know, Mark. Out of fuel.
Seriously?
Yup, it's telling me that I had 3 laps of fuel left. And I'm out of fuel. Unreal.
I'd fire your pit chief, man.
Yeah, you're not kidding.
Okay, Trey.
White flag, one more to go.
You're not for position for me, Garrett. Don't worry. Hey Aaron, I'll lift. You too, Mike.
What?
Nice defense, Volker. That was pretty good.
Okay, thanks. Put enough pressure on me. Thanks.
2 minutes to go. 2 minutes.
Great race, Patrick. That was awesome.
Place. There's the finish. Well done.
Way to hold your mud, Trey.
Let's keep the radio clear until the track is clear, so got drivers running. Thank you.
Car 43 and 37, head to the waiting room, please.
That was nice racing with you, 43. Sorry for the bump halfway through.
What's your speed limit in the pits? Pit lane speed limit is 40 miles per hour.
Good to see you back racing, George.
Thanks, pal. Thanks, pal.
300 feet. 100 feet.
Well, there we go. Well, for my first PCA Club Class race, and the first race, a national race that I've been in since Series 5, I think that I can walk away holding my head pretty high. Did okay, didn't perform as well as I would like to. Part of that is that I traveled all this last week, so my last laps in this car were last Friday. So I didn't do any practice at all this week. I just didn't have the time with some other stuff going on. And I don't like this car all that much. I like the 991. The 991, you always knew that that car was ready to kill you. And it told you every opportunity that it was going to kill you. It wanted to kill you. And so you stay on edge with that car a little bit more. I think the 992, it's easier to drive. That part is definitely true. But the problem is that it lulls you into complacency. And then when you take your attention away from it, even for just a split second, that's when it bites you. And it's really weird the way it bites you. Like a couple of the places where I had problems, just suddenly the car got light and it wasn't really clear what was going on and my inputs weren't really helping anything as I tried to pedal the car back into submission. And that's a rough feeling car. So I've got to work a little bit harder with this car and learn it. Luckily enough, Sebring, I did a race last night with North America Racing League. I do a race tomorrow. It's a 12-hour at Sebring with the Schadenfreude fodder crew of Rob Cottle and the Jeffs, Jeff Williams and Jeff Rosenthal. The four of us will be in the 5 a.m. Pacific, 6 a.m. Mountain time start, which I think is the third of the different segments tomorrow. So that'll be a lot of fun. So gotta hurry up, get this video done, get it published, and go to bed so I have a good night's sleep. But I also have two other races at Sebring as well, one of which will be in this car in this particular series. So I like that track a lot, so I think I'm going to have a much better time. I may be able to avail myself a little bit better. I think that if I had a little bit more practice, I could have definitely made top 15. Obviously, I was only one position back. Having started in position 20, qualified horribly. I finished in 16th. I think that had I not made the few mistakes that I did make, I could have easily been at least three, maybe four positions higher. I don't think I had a top 10 in me tonight. I didn't have the same pace as the really fast guys. And, you know, that is what it is. I did manage to get only two incidents. And mostly that's because the 0Xs on the Armco were kind of gimmies. Damaged the car, slowed me down. But didn't cost that much in terms of incident point. I got my first one avoiding a spinning car in front of me. And I don't really recall where I got the second one. I think that I just went offline and caught the edge of the track and got one incident point. That may have been that second kind of semi-spin where I did catch Armco. It may have taken me off track. But anyway, regardless... No. It was an exit of turn one, I think, where I got it. I overcooked turn one. Anyway, regardless, two incident race isn't all that bad, although the company you keep really tells you a lot about, you know, how well you're doing is there aren't a lot of incident points in this particular class. That's the step up, right, is that these guys can control the car, keep it out of trouble, not hit other people. And the coolest part of this race, too, was kind of the side-by-side action. That was a lot of fun until I screwed it up. So all things being equal, I'm pretty happy with this. I hope that you enjoyed watching as much as I enjoyed driving it. And please come back and watch next week at Sebring. Should be a real hoot. Like and subscribe, all that good stuff. Thanks for watching, and good night. Spaß macht allem Sport.